This is John Locke, and today we're talking about Google Chrome marking non-HTTPS sites as insecure and what that means for your site. Welcome back. This is John from Lockedown Design and SEO. Starting in July of 2018, Google Chrome is going to be marking any non-HTTPS sites as insecure. What does that mean? So normally websites by default, they run on HTTP, which is a protocol. Basically you just put stuff up on the web, but it's insecure. SSL certificates, which make that little green lock in your browser bar that tell you that a site is secure, that is HTTPS. So for the past 3 years, Google, they've been basically telling like webmasters, site owners, people of that nature, that they want people to be turning toward HTTPS. In the past, SSL certificates would cost anywhere from $50 to $300 a year, depending on the level of encryption that you wanted for your site. So in the past few years, a service called Let's Encrypt, which is completely free, has made the barrier of entry to getting a basic SSL certificate very low. So we build a lot of our sites on the WordPress platform. The vast majority of managed WordPress hosts that are out there, including Kinsta, WP Engine, Flywheel, they all partner with Let's Encrypt to offer free SSL certificates as part of their service. Migrating to HTTPS can be a little tricky, but it's not as tricky as it used to be in the past. Remember that Google does look at HTTPS as a totally different site. Most of the managed WordPress hosts out there, they have site-wide redirects to where if there are links out there that have HTTP, it's going to automatically redirect people who click those links to your HTTPS site. So why this is important and why this is happening, there's a lot of focus on security and privacy in the last few years. That was starting like even years ago. Basically, the point is, if you have any type of contact form on your site where it's collecting people's name, email address, or phone number, that SSL certificate, that encryption, that HTTPS is going to mean that that information is transmitted through the internet securely. That's part of the reason for it. And the other part of it is just the right thing to do for your visitors to make sure that if they're filling out any sort of form on your site, that information is encrypted, that information gets to the destination securely. So if you have a website right now and it's July of 2018 or later, and you're seeing that warning in Chrome, if people are going to your site in the Chrome browser and they're seeing like a warning that this site is insecure, that's why it is. Your site most likely is either still on HTTP or your SSL certificate is misconfigured in some way. There are a lot of ways to solve this problem. You can either purchase an SSL certificate. Most hosting companies, they have arrangements with SSL companies, so they could facilitate that on their own and configure it and install the SSL for you. There are also third-party places out there that offer SSL certificates. You want to get a decent amount of encryption. The other thing you can do is, if you have a WordPress site, if you're on one of these hosts like WP Engine or Kinsta or Flywheel, they can set you up with the SSL certificate through Let's Encrypt, which basically rolls over every 90 days and auto-renews. You basically set it up once, it auto-renews through your host. It's just a way of making the web a little bit more secure. I think it's a great program. If you feel like you need extra levels of encryption, there are SSL certificates that you can go out there and purchase. But again, if you're seeing this in Chrome, you need to get an SSL certificate. So what you can do, get with a web developer. You don't want your customers coming to your site through the Chrome browser and seeing this warning that your site is insecure. Other browsers might do that in the future as well. It seems to be the way that the web is going, just evolving and getting better. So this is just one of those things that you have to keep up with. On most decent web hosting, this should be relatively pain-free to set up. If you have any questions about it, you can definitely get with your web developer or your web agency and have them help you out with it. So if you have an SEO question that you'd like to see answered, go ahead and put it in the comments below. We'll go ahead and get it in a video for you. This is John Locke. My business is Lockedown Design and SEO, and we help manufacturers and industrial companies getting more traffic from Google, getting them more requests for quotes. Don't forget to subscribe. Peace. It's transmitted through the internet. If you there are, so that's a